Hello everyone, welcome back to RollPlay Solum Week 41. It's been a while since we've played, so I'm sure this intro might be a little bit longer than most, so just bear with us. We'll start with Ryan. What's going on? You're already smiling, so something funny must have occurred.
No, nothing funny, man. Okay, so I've been reading over my level 3 Warlock spells and what's possible in the future, and it just looks really cool, so I'm excited to play my character.
Gotcha. What's the coolest thing you've seen thus far? Do you want to reveal this?
Look it up. Well, no. I'll just show in the game, because it's also stuff that'll happen in later levels.
Gotcha. Is it cooler than my monk ability, which may occur in another show, where I can either instantly kill someone by snapping my finger when I want them to die, or do 10d10 damage to them if they pass the success, or if they successfully save versus it?
What the fuck level is your monk?
I don't have this ability yet, but I may get
that ability
if I reach level 20.
Yeah. No. Those are a little bit better than my level 3 spells,
yeah.
Fuck. Dude, it's fucking crazy, man. You go up and you like punch someone and it makes their inside shake, and you can like decide if you want to just kill them or if you want it to wait. And then if they
It's like the exploding palm from
it
Kill
is.
Bill.
It's called like it's one of the quivering palm hair. No, open hand paths or something like that. I don't know. It's fucking hilarious though.
That's sick. That's awesome.
So and it's level 17, not 20. I might make it there. We'll see.
But yeah, I'm excited to play my warlock, and so that's why I was smiling at the beginning of the episode.
What's been going on in the life of Ryuzilla, aka MLG Ryan?
Very recently, I am offering a $50 reward to anybody that
still
gets me that Twitter account.
I believe that's
still
been in effect for a year. So.
Yes, if you get me the @Ryuzilla Twitter account, I will give you $50, whoever is out there.
Same offer for LivinPink, by the way. Get that girl to give me my Twitter.
This guy is just like, he's squatting on it, man, and he's not responsive. He makes no tweets. He's just sitting on the name. It's annoying.
The girl does the same for me. It's terrible. Terrible.
Well, I guess now is as good a time as any to tell you guys I own both those Twitter accounts. And,
suck it.
Just kind of holding on to it, waiting for the market to go up. You got to get a little bit more famous, Ryan. Jen, you're almost there. But
all right, fair enough. I could just pay you back the Super Bowl bet money if you want.
I'll give you 10-1 on what's your team, the Panthers. Winning the Super Bowl. How's that sound? $50.
What about making it into the playoffs a little bit more reasonable?
It's so bad. Ryan and I, before a single fucking football is thrown in the regular season, he goes 3-1 on the Seahawks winning the Super Bowl. 3-1 is what we did. And I'm like, yeah, I'll take that bet. And I came one
so
hand off
winning,
away
too.
From fucking winning that bet, too.
Indeed.
God. The sickest call ever.
I have been watching a shitload of House of Cards recently.
Did you finish season 3 yet?
I'm one episode off.
Okay, I'm two episodes off, so.
Yeah,
well, don't talk about it yet.
Well, okay.
I'll just say it's good.
Yeah, it's good.
You know who my favorite, like, non-main character is?
Is it the mayor of D.C.?
No.
That's my Bailey, that's my favorite.
My favorite is Doug.
Doug's pretty
good. Yeah. I love Doug.
You know,
man.
Doug's in, what's it called? Person of Interest is where I first saw him from. And also, the computer hacker is in there as well.
I like the computer hacker. He's also in Always Sunny. He's in a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
He's one of the birds.
But I like that whole, like, hacker, like, FBI, you know, like, spy storylines type stuff. So I think that's really cool.
Yeah. House Cards is good. Although, we were talking about this on the West Marches. The product placement is absolutely insane in this season.
I haven't noticed it.
Really? They
like
pull out
maybe
the first season?
Give me an example and I'll...
Like the fourth, maybe the third episode, someone has like their Microsoft tablet and they're behind a desk and they show him, he's like, hold on, let me make this bigger for you. He stands up, walks over to the TV, and then it shows him flicking the Surface to the TV, and then it goes big on the TV, and he goes, that was easy.
Oh, yeah, I do remember that happening.
It's literally like 10 seconds.
That was actually very obvious, because he goes, here, let me make it easier, and then he like, that was, okay.
And he's like, wow, that was really easy, or something like that. And then they go back to talking about, like, who knows what.
Not to come over the top, but if any of you watch Modern Family, they just did an episode where they're like, it's exciting, it's all from social media perspective. It was the most commercial anything you'll ever see ever, actually, to come
if I had to pick any character from TV to be my dad instead of my dad, it would be him.
Yeah.
The guy from Modern Family. I love that dude. He has so many dad jokes.
Awesome show. But that episode was hilarious. Like, Ann and I are huge fans, and we watch it, and we're just like, oh, this is bad. This is like, they're not even choking us with consumerism.
That's ABC,
like,
right? That's on ABC? Huh? Is that show on ABC? Okay. They've gotten kind of bad.
It's a great show. It's a great show, but that episode was like if Bill Gates busted through like a Kool-Aid man and just was like, buy my shit! Like, that would be less surprising than what happened the entire time.
Oh, God. I think some of that might be like network-driven, because ABC's been...
Oh, yeah.
Dude, like, we're just going to go off on a complete tirade here. On Once Upon a Time, they've gotten like so desperate for characters that... like. Cruella DeVille from the 101 Dalmatians is in it. Then there's the big Ursula from Little Mermaid. She's in there. And then there's like some other, and they're like the trio of terrible or some shit. It's gotten bad on that show in terms of just stretching for it.
That show didn't start off great, though, to be honest.
The first season was pretty good. The second season started to flounder.
I've watched three seasons for some dumb reason, and I'm going to try to stick with it. But
maybe I've only watched the bad, but I've just every episode I've watched has been pretty... It's got a lot of cleavage, though. A lot of cleavage in that show, which is great.
It's true.
If you're a real sadist for terrible shows, by the way, that somehow pass for decent for other people, watch the show Rain, R-E-I-G-H-N, or G-A-N. That is one of the most god-awful shows you could possibly watch. Anna loves it, but she recognizes she hates it. She hates it and loves it. She's trapped.
Have you watched Empire yet? Everyone's been talking about how good Empire is, and I haven't started watching it. It's like the Fox.
I haven't heard of any of these shows.
Empire's like a... it's on Fox, and it's like a... I don't know how to describe it. It's like an R&B family or like a rap family or something like that, like taking over the music empire or some shit. I don't know. Got like the best reviews of the year so far for TV. Anyways, Ryan, what have you been up to? what are you playing like on stream lately?
I've actually been playing a lot of Heroes of the Storm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been enjoying that game a lot, man. Like a lot of it comes from the fact that there are in-game meters that you can tell exactly if you're like crushing everybody in damage or doing the most healing or whatever. But yeah, I've been enjoying that game a lot. Here's the storm.
Level 40?
No, I'm like level 30 though. From level 30 to nothing in the past couple weeks. So.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
That's good.
I'm planning on doing ranked once I hit. I think it's 30, maybe 40.
I think 40
is ranked. Play
ranked. That's what I was asking.
When I can play ranked, I will be probably doing that as well.
Cool stuff.
Yep.
Jeff, what's been going on with you, ma'am?
I was, speaking of TV, I was actually, there's going to be a BBC America show called Almost Royals. I'm going to be on an episode of that.
You're
going to
be on an episode of that?
No, I'm on an episode of that.
What?
I'm going to be featured in an episode of that. Yeah, it's amazing. Like, Anna, a couple weeks ago, was like, hey, do you want to do this interview at the Alameda House? And I was like, sure, whatever. You know, that's my job. That's what I do. And I'm like, what is this about? You know, what am I doing? And they're like, oh, it's a couple of British people. It's for BBC America. It's a reality show. They want to, interview people from esports. And I was like, oh, okay. Like, this is what I do all the time. So I show up, and that's all I know about it. I didn't look into it at all because that's how I roll. And they knock on the door, and they're like, I'm like, so who are they? And they're like, oh, they're super rich, like mega rich country people from England. They don't know anything about technology. I was like, okay. And so it's reality TV, which I've been on before, so they're just kind of like, go to the door and answer the door for them. So I answer the door, and they're sitting there in pearl necklaces, ridiculous, brother, sister, and they're like, hello. And me being me, I'm like, oh, we don't want any Bibles, thank you. And I'm about to, like, hang up on, or, like, close the door on them as a joke, and they're like, no, we don't have any Bibles. a hit. They're like completely like stone quiet, and I was like, oh my god. We come in, they come in, and it's all stage. We're supposed to be asking about, you know, they're like, so you play computer games? And we're like, yeah. And they're like, but don't you want to have friends and have sex with women? And they're saying this shit, and I'm just like, well, I'm married. I still have sex. And they're like, likely story, right? And they're just like, they're saying little things like that. And then we sit down, and they're interviewing us about esports, and I, like, I'm trying to troll them the whole time because it was so stupid. Like, they were just completely aloof. And we were talking about, they're like, do you have fans? And I was like, yeah, yeah, we have enough people that like write fanfic about us. And they're like, what's fanfic? And it's like, well, take Suppy here, and imagine a story written about him having sex with, you know, another pro gamer, and it gets really detailed. And they're like, why would someone write about coitus between two men? and Suppy is there with me. He's the other guy, and he's like,
he's probably super deadpan.
He's, yeah, oh yeah, he had no idea. He was the most gullible thing on the entire planet Earth. So he's like, well, I don't know why people would do that, but sometimes it just kind of helps them get closer. And he's like, you know, if you and I like get really, if we hit it off, you could even write about me too. And he's like, I don't want to write about you having sex, Suppy. And then we ended up talking about shaving pubic hair, and the girl, the sister, was like, she was like, if I went to a barber in America and asked him to shave my bits, would he do it? And we were like, no, probably not a barber. And she's like, good. I don't want a barber's hands on my bits down there. Like, just really weird shit like that. And the whole time, I'm just like, God, these people are so weird. And it was only at the end, like, we did this for 2 hours, and they had us teach them how to play a game of StarCraft, and the whole premise was they've never touched a computer in their life. So that was frustrating as all get out. But it was, again, it ends up being that they're trolling me. The only time I started to catch on to them, and it was ridiculous shit like this the whole time, so I thought I was making comedy gold, like, by trolling them, and they were going to have this on the show. But the girl beats the guy in this game, and she starts fucking crying her eyes out, like, sobbing right there. And everyone's looking at her like, what the fuck? But it's been so ridiculous for me that I don't give a fuck. I'm just like, you know, oh, it's in a digital world. Like, don't worry about it. She's like, why did you force me to kill my brother like that? And he's like, he's standing behind her. And again, he's got his thumb like this. He does it the whole time. He's like, she's very emotional. One time she came to a rugby match that I was in, and I got kicked in the ball. And he's standing next to Anna, Suppy, and me. And he's saying it just like this. He says, the ball hit me down here. And right where the fish meets the chips, it cut the head off just at the top. And he's looking at me the whole time he's saying this, and I'm staring into his eyes. And just for a second, I see the corners of his mouth twerk up a little bit, and his eyes, like, fluctuate. And I was like, the whole time! Like, I was getting trolled the whole fucking time. Like, we would take a break, and I'd go to the director, and I'd be like, yeah. Well, I kind of was like, you're going to include a lot of this in the actual show, right? And he's like, oh, yeah, mate. Yeah, yeah, they're crazy, aren't they? And I'm like, yeah. I'm like, what's the show called again? And he said, United States of England, friend. And I was like, oh, okay. And I Google it. Nothing comes up. And I'm just like, oh, shit, it's a tiny show. Nobody cares. But he was giving me a troll name because if I would have figured out in the middle of it,
yeah, you would have.
I would have then known. So,
huh.
They all got me. Like, fucking Bryce. I'm like, can you believe these guys? He's like, I know, man. They're really weird. And Anna the whole time's like, I can't. I like, go over to her at break, and I was like, Anna, I'm in troll heaven right now.
Oh, so they all knew about it?
They all knew. Oh, only okay. Me and Suppy did not know.
Wow.
So, then the comedians, they left, and they never came back to say, like, oh, that was fun, and nothing like that. It was just like, they're get gone. Fucked when they got out of there.
So when is this supposed to air? Did they give you...
I mean, when it does, I'll tell everyone that their episodes are online. It's Almost Royal, so you can check out a lot of that. It's on TV as well, but just they also put it online. They gave us no timetable. It's like a pretty big production, real show. Like, the cameras they had in there.
Yeah, I think it's on Bravo or something like that. Like,
yeah, it's some big show.
It's on, no, it's on BBC America. Derp. That's what you just said. I'm an idiot. But yeah, season 2 is currently on running now. So yeah, I want to see, I can't wait to see when
you're on. We'll be on the technology episode. They're also going to go... They're LARPing with zombie LARPists, survivalists. Like, they do the funniest. They have the best job ever. They just show up. They said the things they said. She was like, my Uncle Lenny has a camera in my bedroom. The girl saying this, to make sure that I don't get in trouble at night. And it just, like, is quiet. And I'm like, yeah, you never know what could happen in a girl's bedroom. And they don't respond at all.
That sounds amazing.
Yeah, and they're like, they're like making online handles, and they're like, what should our name be? And I'm like, oh, I don't know. what would you like it to be? And he goes, Jamaican. And I'm like, oh, okay. And I'm like, they're like, do we play with anything Jamaican? I was like, no, no voodoo dolls. And he goes, and they both look at me and they're like, that's racist. And I was like, not really. It's cultural. And they're like, no, it was pretty racist what you said. And I'm like, they're professional comedians. They're amazing. But yeah, when it does go out, I'll tweet it and stuff like that, and we'll all have a good laugh at my expense. Because again, the whole time, I'm not going to try to lie, like, oh, I had an idea. No, I had no fucking idea.
That's awesome.
I was trying to be a dick, and they got me, so.
That's awesome. We'll have to watch that. I'm excited to watch that for sure, so let me know when it goes out.
Yeah, absolutely.
Neil, what's been going on with you, man?
Nothing nearly that interesting. I had my stage one of my honeymoon for Tet, for the Lunar New Year here. We cruised around Saigon, now called Ho Chi Minh, and went up to these Coochie tunnels, which were like the VC tunnels during the Vietnamese-American War.
Yeah, what? Excuse me?
I know, I've heard of that.
It's something like that. The pronunciation kills me, but it's something like Coochie.
That's right, you're saying it right.
I'm like 5 years old right now.
Coochie tunnels and Ho Chi Minh.
The Coochie tunnel, yes.
Yeah, tunnel. Yeah, I mean, it's like the old VC tunnels from the war, and you get to, like, they're pretty fucking touristized now, capitalized now. And there may be a communist country, but there's a lot of capitalism with their, like, war memorabilia. So you, like,
wait,
go
did you
through,
get to go see
the
did you see, like, the I was someone from Giant Bombwind did this, I think, and he was talking about how they have, like, all of the traps that they used to set for the Americans.
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard that shit was real fucked up.
Yeah, those are, like, really, because the traps aren't designed to kill you. The traps are designed to, like, wound you, so everyone has to take care of you.
Yeah.
So everyone standing around is like, holy fuck, that guy's been, like, impaled by 15 spikes.
Yeah, yeah, they were, like, pit traps that had spikes at the bottom.
All sorts of pit traps that, like, come spikes from the sides, spikes from underneath. There'll be, like, an 8-foot pit with just, like, big iron. They're not just, like, spikes. They're spikes with, like, hooks on the end of it. So, like, it gets impaled into you, and then, like, the spike has to be cut off of you. And it was fucking gnarly.
Fucked up,
and then, like, there's a gift shop there where you can, like, buy memorabilia.
Oh, yeah. Neil, we still got to work on your storytelling, friend.
I loved it.
No, but that's the point. It's like you're going and looking at, like, all these fucking, you're looking at these weird traps, you're, like, crawling through these tunnels, you hear gunshots going off in the background because there's a shooting range where you can, like, go and shoot AK-47.
He did, like, the same thing. Yeah. He went and shot the AK-47.
Like, abandoned American M16s and, like, M60s.
You didn't shoot the gun? Like,
I did.
Oh, you did? Oh, okay. I was about to be upset.
No. My wife and I fired AK-47s.
How many bullets
and
did you
M16s.
Shoot?
Not too much. They were pretty pricey. They're like $1.75 a shot
for
a round.
Yeah.
And we only had, like, 10 minutes. So we kind of kept it down to, like, what was it? 30 on each gun for each of us.
Yeah. Okay.
I
heard that stuff is absolutely crazy because there's no, you don't sign anything. There's just, like, an AK that's in, like, this housing unit that's kind of
like, welded,
like,
onto a turret, so it only shoots one direction. You can't, like, hit anyone.
And they just come over
and, like, here you go. Yeah. Go for it.
It's insane.
And there's just, like, a giant pile of expended rounds that have just been, like, shot out of the thing, just, like, stacking up next to you.
It's kind of crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, so that was fun. And then I got to go hang out on a beach, on, like, a really nice beach with a bunch of crazy sunburned Russians, and got pulled aside while I was walking down the beach by, like, a Vietnamese guy. I was like, oh, hello. Comes over and, like, pulls me away from my wife and then, like, puts his arm around me, and I look around and there's, like, 5 people with cameras, and they all, like, start taking pictures of, like, the white guy on the beach with the Vietnamese tourist. And then, like, he pulls over a couple of, like, cute little, like, younger, you know, 19, 20-year-old Vietnamese kids, girls, and, like, they come over, and, like, it's the 2 girls and, like, the old fat guy with no shirt and then me, and they're all like, yay! And I'm just like, this is really uncomfortable. I don't know what to do.
Yeah, you shouldn't have agreed to any of that.
I don't know. It's like some random guy on the beach, and we're, like, walking, like, huh, yeah, sure, what do you want, buddy?
The,
like,
words fuck off come to mind. The universal language known as fuck off.
Yeah.
So.
But it was pretty fun. We had a good time. I got pulled over by a cop on my motorcycle.
You don't say fuck off there. That's not.
No.
Yeah,
but it was literally, like, it's the Lunar New Year, and we got warned about this, that the cops are going to pull over as many tourists as they can just to, like, try and extort them for money. Like, the cop was just literally asking for a bribe. He's like, you should be driving with your brights. Of course, this isn't, like, in Vietnamese, and he's, like, flipping my lights around, yelling at me in Vietnamese. And then he pulls out the equivalent of, like, 25 US and starts pointing at it and, like, puts his hand out, like, give me 25 bucks right now. Your lights weren't on the right setting. I'm like, what? What the fuck, dude? And just, like, chattering at him in English until he just, like, points at enough, and I open my wallet and have, like, no money in it because we heard about this. So we stash all our money in our pockets, and, like, you pull out the wallet and it's empty. And he just, like, waves you on and keeps going. So that was fun.
Vietnam sounds fantastic. That's been my week.
Sounds awesome.
It just sounds really dope.
It's been great. It's
a place to live. Cannot imagine how amazing it is.
But it was, I mean, yeah. It was
in
fun.
The old
and
days,
the food,
their traps were spears and stuff like that. Now it's just bad internet and getting you guys to teach them English, it feels like, right?
That's true. And bribing the cops, yeah.
Lots of bribes, lots of people like selling you things at double the price. Which, by the way, like you're paying double the price, but you're still paying like 1/5 of what you'd pay in the United States. You're like, wow, this is really cheap. And then you talk to your Vietnamese friend, and you're like, oh man, you got screwed. You paid way too much for that. And you're like, oh no, I paid $1 for 20 eggs. I guess I got screwed.
Got him.
That's how much 20 eggs are? $1?
No, I have no idea. I'm pulling numbers out of my
ass. I was like, damn, that's kind of impressive. This whole Vietnam thing can't be that bad if it's that cheap.
Well, I think we bought 12 eggs for 30 dong. Because their money is called the dong here.
They all worship J-Dong over there, yeah.
30 dong.
Yeah, which is like $1.50. And that was overpriced. I think we're supposed to get like 12 eggs for 15 or 20 dong, which is like 75 cents to a dollar. So yeah, so it's like a half price, I guess, for eggs in the U.S. But, I mean, you can get a liter of beer, like a full, I'm sorry, 2 liters of beer for $1, $1.50.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
It's pretty good. Yeah. Can't be all that bad. Seems pretty accommodable.
A liter of beer?
2 liters, a double liter of beer for $1.50.
Like in the Coke bottle type?
Well, yeah, like basically you take a recycle, like you drink a liter of Coke, and then you just bring your liter of Coke to them, and they'll just fill it up for you on the spot, and then just hand it back to you.
With beer, crazy. That's crazy.
Mm. We had a party here earlier today, yesterday, I don't know, someday. And so we went out to like buy some beer for the party. We bought like a 24 pack, or I guess it's a 20 pack here beer. Get it home, start putting it in the refrigerator, only to find out that 2/5 of it had actually been replaced by workers at the factory with Coke. Like, you know, instead of like packing the beer into the thing, they like started drinking the beer and started putting Coke cans in the box instead. So you go out to buy a bunch of beer and you get a bunch of Coke instead. It was fun.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Vietnam sounds like it might be fun. For a week.
It's fun. It's it's a new experience.
Let's
I'm
all go to Vietnam. We'll take everyone else out there, you know, and then we'll try to survive.
Role play Vietnam.
It'll happen for a week. We'll also pitch it to NBC. We'll try to be Survivor Vietnam. Jin will be all over it.
Yay!
She can win Survivor. Oh. It'll be great.
I love Survivor.
It'll be great.
So that's that. Cool. Life's been good.
Cool. Jen, you've been traveling, or at least you're back from traveling, I
assume. So I don't remember last time we spoke. I guess I went to Paris, right, for work?
Yes.
And I ended up working more than I thought, so I didn't get to enjoy Paris very much, but I have high hopes of going back at some point and having more time. It just happened this way. What else did I do? I went for a ski weekend.
Snowboard?
I skied, but I haven't skied in the last 14 years, so it was really tough.
Skiing is like such a less cool thing than snowboarding. Like, if you see someone on skis, you're just like, man, that guy's a fucking nerd. But if you see someone snowboarding, you're like, that guy's fucking awesome.
I don't give a shit.
Is that just my like convoluted view, or is everyone everyone in agreement?
That's what everyone's thinking.
Okay,
I disagree. Really? Yeah, I'm dissenting opinion on this. Like, there's a lot of really sick skiers. And they can go faster. Like, they're super sick, but I snowboard. I don't ski.
I see.
Well, so I ski.
But I don't think they're nerdy.
So that's, I just had to get that. I've 28 years, I've been thinking that. I just had to get it off my chest. So what else? What else have you been doing?
It hurt a lot. I was really bad. And the guys were stupid. They were like, ah, Jen, let's just do a, like, normal difficulty thing. And it's like, you do realize that I'm the equivalent of an 8-year-old trying ski for the first time. Like, this is not going to go well. So I fell a few times. But it was really nice still. I think I'll go back to ski at some point.
Nice.
And oh shit, I watched Sharknado 2. I didn't even see the first one, but I watched the second one today.
How did you like?
Well, how are you gonna follow the story then?
Yeah.
The only movie
that actually works with saying you saw the sequel first is The Raid 2. There's no other movie that you can say you watched the sequel first.
Yeah, I don't. I wonder.
Or any of the Spider-Mans, I guess.
I wonder how they justified the Sharknados. Did they ever justify it in the first Sharknado?
What? Why it exists?
Yeah, like...
Because the Sci-Fi Network wanted views, and so they, like, made this crazy Sharknado thing up and then premiered it on national or cable television. It had, like, one of the best ratings of all times for Sci-Fi when it premiered on there.
Sharknado?
Yeah. God. Sharknado 2. I don't think Sharknado 1 premiered. I'm not sure. I know Sharknado 2 was, like, a huge social media bullshit when it premiered and all the stupidity a couple months back.
And it's so bad. Yeah. And so great that the same
A shark like, jumps out of this fucking sea and bites a helicopter. An airplane. That's what it was.
Yeah.
It's one of the worst things I've ever seen.
And it's so crazy. The girl's, like, hanging on to, like, the plane with, like, two hands. And then the guy's like... Quick, a shark is coming. Grab a gun. Then she just, like, takes the gun. No effort whatsoever. And then she's like, pew, 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 shooting at a shark. And then she's okay. It's like, what the fuck?
It's bad.
Yeah, it's really bad. And, like, the acting, because they're, like, pretending, like, the plane is, like, shaking. So they're, like, you can see all the actors going, like. Shaking, yeah. But clearly it's not shaking. It's so bad.
Well, sorry for the spoilers, guys. I didn't mean to. Sorry.
Oh, jeez.
No, Jen. Well, maybe Jen was spoiling too. Whatever.
Oh, whatever. No. I didn't say the ending.
It's true. Don't say the ending.
It was just the beginning. Like, in the 5 minutes, you can see that happen. So it's going to be okay.
You've already done enough damage, Jen. All right.
Sharknado! I think I have to watch the first one now.
You do. You have to. And then watch The Raid 2, because it's a better movie.
Isn't it the cult movie?
What, The Raid?
Sharknado.
Oh, yes, no. Yeah.
God.
It is.
Did you see it, Jeff?
No, I don't. The only movie I saw that was purposely bad was The Room, which it wasn't necessarily purposely bad, which makes it incredible.
Well, you've seen that like 20 times.
Yeah.
So.
I did not hit her. I did not.
You're tearing me apart.
I hate that movie so fucking much. I'm not even
gonna. How can you not?
I'm not even gonna acknowledge it. All right. Apparently, there's like some weird buffering on Twitch right now. Well, tell everyone to refresh, guys, in the chat that's actually watching this. Anything else, Jen?
Nah, that's pretty much it. I'm excited to play D&D.
Cool. I think I gotta get some. Here, this is the signal indicator now. We'll do a plus sign with the hands for some stupid reason. So when you see this in the future, it means that the intro is over. And we're actually role-playing. We all do this. There we go.
Except for Jeff.
Don't
confuse it with Get Fucked YouTube.
Yeah, this is Get Fucked YouTube. This is the intro is over. That's how it is.
Got him.
We all hit level 3. We all... chose. Jeff, you chose last episode, but the three of us...
I'm the bear.
Yeah, you're the bear. The three of us chose our subclass. Are we going to reveal this in-game, or do you guys want to just say what you chose? I don't... Jen, you didn't get to choose anything. You just got new spells, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Ryan, you want to just do it in... I'll leave it up to you. Should we reveal in-game or now what we have chosen?
It's going to come out soon enough anyway, so I will just reveal. I have chosen the Pact of the Chain.
Is your character now 2 chains?
3 chain, actually.
3 chain, okay.
Wow. Yeah, I had to one up. This means that I basically have a bro now.
Okay.
I have a familiar that
you,
can
you
do...
May, you learn the find familiar spell.
Yes.
So you may summon a familiar whenever
but it's
you
like.
But
it's like familiar on steroids. It's not like the shitty familiar spell that wizards have. It's like better.
Hey, my familiar is one. So yeah. Which type of familiar can you get?
I'm going with an imp.
Okay.
There are four different ones.
Is it small or tall? Like, what does it look like?
I can actually change its appearance each time I summon it. And he also can shapeshift. So he's pretty, like, versatile.
Where is his shapeshifting coming in? Where are you reading that shit?
I'll link you. Hold on.
Okay.
I could be... yeah, okay.
So, like, can you make it tiny? Like, bug-sized?
Oh, I can make it tiny, yeah.
Can you make it big?
Can you make it big?
Yeah, exactly.
How big?
Hey-o! Dick jokes early and fast.
Indeed. I don't know entirely. I'm gonna leave this up to Neil. I'm gonna link you, and you can give me your impression.
Neil, two birds, one stone. Also, how big is his nose getting as he leveled up as well? I understand that that's
does
growing.
It grow? Yeah, does it grow?
Yeah.
Forgot about that.
I mean, not as he levels, but just over time, it's okay. You know, it got this big bubbly thing, and then over the next few days, it kind of just swelled up a little bit, and the hair that you like keep trimming off or yanking out keeps growing back. It's
okay.
It's just kind of hideous.
Okay.
Just let us know when it falls off his head or it weighs him down that he can't look up, is what I want to know.
Interesting.
Okay.
I Skyped you, Neil.
Yeah, I see it.
Look, dude, the bigger the mole, the better the holy moly works.
Yeah.
That's his trick.
That's my sex move.
Nice. I keep saying thief, but thief is actually an archetype of rogue. So for rogue, I actually chose the assassin. I wanted to go for the arcane trickster, but then I realized I had to look up all these spells, and it was going to be really complicated. So I'm not doing that. We're going with assassin instead. Nice. And so that just gives me proficiency with a disguise kit and the poisoner's kit and some other things that we'll just reveal in combat when they come to fruition.
Okay, so your imp, when you summon it, can shape change. The imp can use an action to polymorph into a beast that resembles a rat, a raven, a spider, or back to its true form. Its stats are the same in each form, except for the speed changes and flight methods. Any equipment that is wearing or carrying is not transformed, and it reverts to its true form when it dies. Also, magical darkness does not block an imp. They have advantage on saving throws against spells, and they can turn invisible until it attacks, or it can turn invisible at will, pretty much, as an action.
There you go.
It's pretty sweet.
Do you have a name for your imp?
He doesn't have the imp yet. He has the spell. Let's not jump.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Neil, where were we? What was the...
You guys are in Valark, which I have represented the party with this blue minotaur holding a two-handed something-something stabby-stabby double axe.
Awesome.
I don't know. It looks like a double-ended axe or something. I don't fucking know what it is, but this is going to represent the party on the map. And you guys are here in Valark. Awesome. You are on your way all the way up to, I believe it is Onskar, to get some jade and bring back down to Jade Run for a man that you have met down there. But for now, you have arrived in Valark. You've rested for the night, and you are waking up the next day. Oh, no. You actually got here in the middle of the day. That's right.
Yes.
And I believe there was some discussion of checking out an arena or something.
Yeah.
Because there is a Colosseum here.
I had brought it up to Karn that the arena does still function here in town, and if he wanted to go fight, he could. And I think that's kind of like...
I'm trying to remember that last conversation.
Yeah. I mean, I think that was just that. Like, I said something about the arena being here, and then that's right where we ended. Before we made the decision on if we wanted to leave, if you wanted to go and fight, or what.
I have some things I want to do, but it's just shopping.
So, yeah, I guess
great. I want to go shopping as well.
I proposed to Karn. I'm just like, Karn, do you want to fight?
No.
You don't want to fight? You can make a lot of money.
Really?
Well, it depends on how much money the DM wants to give you, but yeah. You could.
I thought we looked into it last time, and it wasn't that worth it.
Yeah, it might be the feel like the whole goblin ears thing, where it's like, well, if you kill like 50 goblins, maybe you can feed yourself for a day.
Neil, someone that's been here in the town, what do I know is like what you can make from the arena? And do I know it to be like to the death, or is it to
no, most fights are to someone surrendering, and it's considered bad form to kill someone in a fight that isn't to the death. Those fights don't make too much money. You can make a lot of money, but it's like the fighters who build a name for themselves and will attract larger audiences tend to make the bigger money. So someone coming up and like, all right, I want to come to the arena and make a name for myself. Like, you don't make very much money at first. It's like as you become a gladiator over time.
Okay.
Or if you show up and you like challenge a badass, specifically challenge a badass and then beat them, you can make some money.
Do I get experience for fighting in the arenas?
Yeah, totally.
Okay, so as he explains all this to me, Karn ponders this and goes, yes.
Okay, well, how about we go over there? We'll check it out. I think these two want to go shop around town, so we'll go visit the arena, and then Dante and Varnoosh, you guys want to go shop?
Indeed.
Karn fights ugly one shop.
Yep, I agree. The pretty ones are going to the arena. I just kind of like walk off with Karn behind me.
Yep.
I tighten my bandana a little bit.
I'm like, you know, Dante, when you do this, I'm sure you can get the ladies like this. It's okay. They're lying. I think we're the good looking ones.
You know, I probably can't get them with my looks, but I do have a command spell, if you know what I'm saying.
That is a good plan.
He watches.
Varnoosh, what are you shopping for today?
Ooh, I am looking for the component for the Find Familiar spell.
Ah, so I think we are headed to a reagent shop. We're looking for
looking for some charcoal, some herbs, and a brass brazier.
Brazier, not a brazier.
Yeah. Brazier is
this character doesn't wear braziers, for God's sakes.
So we want to go to a reagent shop, Neil.
Okay. Valark is a fairly large place. Magic is not unheard of in this area, but in most towns you probably wouldn't be able to find one, but Valark is, as I said before, a fairly large place. You can definitely find a wizard selling all sorts of components and what's nots about. You head to the... It's not really a quarter. I hate to call it the magic quarter, but there's a small square in one section of the town that is kind of like the wizard, warlock, sorcerer section of town. It's where all the spellcasters hang out and have all of their shops. And you can pretty much find whatever common or uncommon reagents that you might need.
Okay. I need a big chunk of mica. I need a couple of snake's tongues, and I need a jar of sweet oil.
Mm. You give him the oil, Neil, I'll make it sweet. You
know that sweet oil. That sweet oil.
Okay. Components are there. Just seeing if they already have a list of the cost of spell components here. Or components. No. Under spell components, maybe? Nope. Okay, so how many snake tongues do you want?
Well, how much does a snake tongue go for?
You can get a snake tongue for 5 copper.
Oh, okay. And it's 10 copper to the silver, right?
Right.
Okay. Well, what are the other components? What do they cost?
You're going to have to give them to me again. What are you looking for?
Sweet oil and a big chunk of mica. Or just a bunch of mica flaked off, however it comes.
Is mica like wood? Is that like
flame? No, it's like it's that stone that's like very layered and flaky.
Oh, okay.
How do you spell mica?
M-I-C-A-H, I think.
C-A-H?
Maybe.
I think it's just M-I-C-A, according to your site.
Okay. How is mica very common? Yeah, it's not too terribly uncommon. Okay, so you can get a chunk of mica for 2 silver. You can get a jar of sweet oil for 5 silver.
Okay. And I'll just buy like 10 snake's tongues, let's say.
Okay. So that's 5 silver for the snake's tongues.
Mm-hmm. You said how much for everything else?
I think 2 silver for the mica and 5 silver for the sweet oil.
Okay, so I pay 12 silver for the reagents.
Cool. And are they expended upon use?
That I don't know. It just says that those are the required reagents.
A snake's tongue and either a bit of honeycomb or a drop of sweet oil.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you don't need the... I see what you mean. Yeah. Okay, cool. So the sweet oil will pretty much last you forever because you've got like a jar of it, unless it gets broken or something. You'll have plenty of sweet oil forever. And I think, so the snake tongues will be expended and the mica... And you just need a chip, yeah. So, the chip of the block of mica will last you forever. The sweet oil will last you forever, and the snake's tongues will be used up one at a time.
Okay.
Cool. Jen, what did you want?
I need the 10 golds worth of charcoal, incense herbs, and herbs. Blah blah blah. And a brace and a brass brazier. Whatever that thing.
Brazier.
Neil, it's a glass lingerie piece.
It's French.
Okay, so it's a brass glass.
Holds his gun in and makes the breast look amazing.
Yep.
So. Gotcha. Yeah,
pretty much.
The brass brazier is kind of like a large fixture that would stand in the ground and you'd put these things in. So if you wanted to buy one, you'd be looking at spending like 60 or 70 gold, and then it would weigh like 30 pounds. You'd have to carry it around with you.
Is there somewhere that would have one, like in the town like last time, or somewhere where I can ask to borrow or something like that?
The wizard at the shop that you're in will let you borrow his, or rent his, as it is, for 1 gold to cast your spell.
Okay, deal. So I remove 11 gold.
Okay.
And I'm doing it as a ritual, by the way.
Okay. It'll still take an hour to cast, but you can do it.
Oh, shit. I only have 7 gold. Oh, and 132 silver pieces. I guess it's fine, though. Is it?
That's another 10. 100 silver pieces is 10 gold.
Okay, so I do...
So you have 13 gold.
Yeah, I'm okay. Yeah.
Ryan, were you going to cast Find Familiar as well?
Yes, I think I would like to do that.
So, 10 gold for resources and 1 gold to rent the brazier.
Well, can't we share the renting of the brazier, or no?
No.
Okay. I tried.
Yeah, the brazier's $10 back then.
Is this thing, like, movable? Is it mobile, or does she have to use it there in the shop?
No, yeah.
You can use brazier wherever you can. You know, you got a connection, basically.
Yeah. Can I borrow her password, is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
you're going to have to do it there in the shop, or it's possible to come across another one elsewhere in the city, but it's going to be kind of hit or miss. Think of the brazier as like a hobo drum that a hobo box that they build a fire in.
I see them all over Orgrimmar, so I know that they like exist in just random spots in cities sometimes.
Our production value is not that high yet, so, you know, there's just the one in the shop, and then, you know, whatever we stumble across at random.
I'll just pay.
Cool. So, 11 gold, and 2 hours pass, and you guys get your familiars. And whatever noises an imp makes.
What sound does the imp make?
What does the imp say?
I imagine it's like chittering or like. Yeah. Is that what you call that?
Sure.
Okay.
That's a Neil chitter.
Does he speak impish or does he what?
We actually speak to each other telepathically. Or
not yet.
Is that until okay? I need the spell, yeah. But we will.
You will.
Can we'll he speak there. Neil? Does he have?
I am looking that up. Imp. Yes, the imp will speak in common with you. Okay. It is summoned and it floats about above your head, and it goes.
He's like that guy from what's that like old green Martian from the cartoons like 30
Darksiders.
Years
no, Marvin the Martian.
The green Martian.
But also you have a familiar in Darksiders.
Not Marvin the Martian. He's like the little green Martian, but it's not Marvin. It's a different one.
Somebody
will know.
And the voice is done by Mark Hamill.
I don't know.
Darkwing Duck. Is that it?
That wasn't it, no.
Damn it. What about Goliath from the Gargoyles series? Is that who you're talking about?
No.
I'll keep.
I'm gonna Google it. I'm gonna find it.
Kazoo.
I think Kazoo is it.
Was he in the Flintstones?
Melvin the Martian? No, that's not.
No, that's.
Yeah, Kazoo
is what everyone's saying. The Great Gazoo. Invader Zim. I hope you mean Invader Zim because that's a great show. Yeah. I don't know who you're talking about, Ryan.
It's like Gazoo or Kazoo. Yes, that's it.
Yeah.
I think it is.
This dude, right?
Yes, that dude. That's who I'm talking about.
Yeah, Flintstones guy.
Oh, okay. Wait, they had aliens in the Flintstones?
Yeah, dude.
What the fuck?
They jumped the shark at some point, dude.
Yeah, that must have been like during the shit.
Story went to shit.
Yeah, story must have just got bad at the end of the Flintstones, man.
He crosses over with the Jetsons. It's all in the same universe.
Wait, he does, really?
Yeah.
Wait, the Jetsons and the Flintstones were in the same universe? Like canonical?
Dude, yeah.
They're sitting down at the board meeting and they're like, "All right, what can we do to boost ratings?" And then they're like, "This is a shit idea, but let's do it."
They're
yeah,
dumb.
A,
they
I think even an episode or two where they
further.
Meet each other and like I don't remember the Jetsons' dad's name, but he runs into I don't remember the other guy's name either.
George Jetson.
Why are we doing this?
I don't
because
know.
That's mind-blowing. If they're in the same universe, man, that's insane.
It's tough because Neil's first started smoking weed at age 3, so you can't really... can't trust anything he's saying about this.
Well, I did grow up in California, guys. I started... Nice
Son, and... finish your cereal and smoke that goddamn blunt. I'm not going to tell you again.
But, Dad, I don't want to smoke the weed.
What the fuck is going on? All right. Are you guys done shopping? What's going on?
Yes.
All right. What are the two of you guys doing?
We make our way to the arena.
All right.
I'm telling Karn about like the people that I've or the different fighters that I saw growing up here and stuff like that. And that I like saw people's head get chopped off and all the different tales of the arena that I know.
He's super happy about all this, smiles and nods, looking around emphatically.
And we kind of just like, we go to wherever like the entrance is, expecting to find the person that runs like the roster or the competitions here, whatever that would be.
All right, it is a young dwarf, well, youngish, right? He's, you know, 67 years old, and he stands in the at the gate to the arena, but not like the front door. It's the like side door where all the contestants go into, and he has an axe at his side, and he is leaning against the wall, whittling a piece of wood. It's just a block right now. Not sure what it will become.
Okay, I approach him. I'm just like, hello, sir. My name is Amos Riverunna. My friend here would like to fight.
Looks up over at Karn and goes, well, what's your name, lad?
Karn.
The Destroyer. That's what
yes.
Karn the Destroyer.
Karn the Destroyer. Huh. All right. Well, what are you looking for? Are you looking to put your life on the line, or are you just looking to have a nice tumble in the arena, make a few coin?
Tumble first.
Tumble. Okay.
Then death.
All right.
I think
well,
what my
let's...
friends he wants to build a reputation and then go for the big prize. I think
yes.
What he's
Everyone does. It's a great thing to do. I got my reputation in the arena. Well, not the Dwarven Arena. Came out here to spread the good word.
Is the Dwarven Arena just shorter? And like, what is it? What do you mean by the Dwarven Arena?
And kind of like deadpans you. You know, I'm taller than you are.
I know. It was supposed to be a joke to make us friendly with one another, not to insult the Dwarven race.
You know how many
Dwarven
short
race.
Jokes I get about the Dwarven Arena? You think
half
that was
as many as most people. He doesn't actually say that, but that would have been great.
I was trying to be quick-witted, and you definitely beat me to it. I just let him finish the sentence.
Anyway, no, it happens to just be underground. That's all.
Oh, okay. Yeah. How does this work? Do you have fights open today? Do you have to register? Do you got to see him swing an axe? How does this go?
Register. You come on in, we find someone that's roughly your skill level, you go out there and you fight, we'll get you there in a day or two, and if you, you know, hopefully you don't die, we'll get you paid a few coins, and if you keep winning fights, you can keep fighting new people. You lose a couple of fights and we're done with you. Unless you want to stick around as cannon fodder, in which case you don't make very much money, but then you get to keep going out and out and out. You know, we always need a person to be beaten.
Do you understand that, Karn?
Yes.
Okay. Well, Karn, do you need me for anything else here?
He kind of looks at you. Manager.
That means I get a bit of your earnings.
Yes.
1 second, Master Dwarf. I like pull Karn aside. I was like, what's the split?
Half.
Half? Okay, that's quite generous. Okay, I'm in agreement with this. I turn back to the dwarf and be like, I believe, can we fight today?
No. It'll take a couple of days to get everything sorted out and find you the right person. Maybe not. If you're in a rush, I mean, you're here to make a name for yourself, right? How quickly do you need a fight?
I mean,
tomorrow.
That's the money that you need.
He says tomorrow, so as his manager, tomorrow.
All right, we can get you a fight tomorrow. Not a problem.
I look up the card and he's like, are you ready?
Yeah. He sticks out his hand at the dwarf.
Dwarf sticks his hand out, shakes it, and says, all right, come on inside. We got to match you up against somebody.
Okay, I fall
and
behind.
And you go inside. You basically swing your axe against a couple of other people and practice and train for a little bit until you find someone that is roughly your same caliber. And the person you end up matching yourself well against is a tallish human. He's like 6'2", but he's a little bit on the scrawny side, and he has a nice big one-handed mace he wears. He also has nice. These blackened, boiled leathers that look like they've seen better days. They're kind of dried and cracked and dirty. And that's the person you end up getting paired off against, and you can fight him tomorrow.
Seems pleased with this. Leaves, I assume. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. You guys head out. I think you're all at full HP.
Yeah, we didn't find anything on the road, I don't think, did we? Did we? I think we saw some goblins and then walked by. Or saw a caravan that was ruined by goblin tracks and then we kept on going.
Right. It takes a while. Yeah, I think you rested in your previous town, so I think you're all at full. So you can grab an inn for the night. That is going to be 2 and 3. That's 5 silver a person. 3 for food, 2 for the inn. For a day of food and drink and sleeping. So everyone chip in 5 silver, and then we can just jump into the combat the next day if you'd like.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm okay with that. Ryan or Jen, do you guys have anything you want to do?
No. Not at all.
Okay. Well, that night we like inform you, or I inform you that Karn's going to fight in the arena and all that stuff tomorrow, and that as his manager, I would like you guys to be in the crowd, making some noise.
He's taking you on him as his manager, has he?
He has, yeah.
Interesting.
It's all in a name, so Karn the Destroyer. Any chance you can think of? Really anything.
We can use any support. We got to get his name out there if we're going to go big.
I think I'm going to go with Destroyer.
Okay, I like the chant. Mm. Make sure that you're wearing your bandana, though, because they're only going to repeat what...
Destroyer!
Exactly. They're only going to repeat what handsome people are saying.
I don't take it off even when I shower. I've become a never nude.
Nice. Well, I mean, for some people, it just...
You're a never nude too?
That's just how it is. That's just how it is. Yeah, the fight's tomorrow. It should be no problem. Just make a lot of noise in the crowd, and we'll go out for dinner afterwards.
Excellent.
All right. So yeah, I think we just depart, go sleep. We all wake up the next day.
All right, everyone, chip in your 5 silver, and then we can hop into the arena.
We could take. You want to take a break right before?
Let's take a break. Yeah.
You sure?
That's a good point. Oh yeah. This is much better.
We'll do the introductions to the arena when we come back. So. First hour is down, guys. Still got 3 hours left for RollPlay Solum. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. We're going to return after this commercial break. We'll see you guys then.